Welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be airbrushing Marcus, but before I get started on spraying Marcus, I just wanted to go over a few things with this new compressor, because I'm going to be using this compressor in the beginning. I'm probably not going to keep using it. I'm going to put it on the floor in a moment, and I'll go back to using my normal compressor, which is the TC2000, which is also a Sparmax compressor. But I picked up this new, it's not new, but it's new to me. It's the Sparmax Zeta. And I picked this up just as a portable, small compressor to go in the other room, because it's not always comfortable to sit here at the desk with all the camera equipment. So if I'm not recording, you know, I'd sooner sit somewhere else sometimes. And even though the compressor that I normally use, the TC2000, is a portable compressor, I've got it linked to a 5-litre tank, and the way that it's linked up, it's part of the desk now, it's underneath, and yeah, it's not going anywhere. So I saw this on eBay, and I managed to pick this up for about £80. The normal retail price for this is nearly £200, and even though I love Sparmax, I wouldn't recommend this as a sort of first compressor. Mainly because you can get the TC2000, which I was, like I say, is the one I normally use, and you can get that for about the same price, about £200. And that comes with two cylinders, not one, so there's only one cylinder inside here. It can be linked to a tank, so you can link it to a 2.5 litre Sparmax tank or a 5 litre Sparmax tank. This cannot be linked to a tank. And the reason for that is this basket holder. This is the on-off switch. So the moment you pick up that airbrush, the compressor kicks in, and it will stay on the whole time that you're using the airbrush. And they're calling it a smart sensor, a power saving function. I call it burning compressor life. Because the TC2000, which came out years and years ago, which is their flagship compressor, they already had a patented on-off switch, which is built into the compressor. So the moment you push down on the trigger, the compressor comes on. So you didn't need none of this crap. Because you can link the TC2000 to a tank, it means it sort of like increases the life of the compressor, because it only comes on for about 90 seconds every sort of 10, 20 minutes, depending on what you're spraying, and then it'll shut off again. Whereas this stays on the whole time. So as far as longevity goes, the TC2000 is gonna beat this hands down. And like I say, there's no upgrade potential. So if you start to enjoy airbrushing and you start to get good and you decide to buy another airbrush, you're gonna have to keep disconnecting it on this one and switching them over. So it's like a sort of a dead end, if you know what I mean. It has its uses. I mean, if I had paid full price for this, I would absolutely have returned it, no questions. I would not pay nearly £200 for this. No, the build quality is fantastic, but because, like I say, the way that it's designed and it can't work with a tank, because you can buy the TC2000 for the same price, and it's such a far superior compressor, I just don't understand who this is made for. I don't understand who Sparmax targeted this for. Like I say, they've already got better products, so yeah. This will work for my needs, which is why I bought it, but like I say, I just wanted to show you it first so that you didn't sort of go and buy something like this. So the colours that I'm going to be using today are Necromancer Flesh, some Createx Illustration Violet. I've also mixed some of this with some white, so I've got a lighter shade, and I also mixed some with a little bit of yellow. So got sort of three different shades of Necromancer Flesh, some purple. I've also watered down a couple of the dark bronze, and I think I used Viking Gold as well. And these have basically been turned into almost washers. I'm actually going to use these first, so try to lift them off the base. Now I'm basically going to do the same thing to the base as what I've done on his belt. It's not finished yet, obviously. Let's move this around. I need some sponge for this. A couple of different types of sponge. Got some fake sea sponge, some natural sea sponge, and some normal sponge. I'm probably just going to use this there, the fake sea sponge. It's really soft. Just going to mix these up. It's pretty much like water. This will be the main colour for this foundation. I'm going to use a little bit of Victorian brass. So I'm just going to dab a little bit of this on here. I'm just going to dab away. I really want to be getting inside the gaps with this as opposed to being on the surface, but that's why I put it on the pointy bit. This is a dry silent sponge, I'm just patting it down. I don't want to create any texture. Just testing it out there. The tone. A bit more dinner. I'm actually going to switch to the Eclipse. So I'm going to lay down a few patches of this. Hope this works. Better work. Lots and lots of nice wet. Very wet. And now I'm going to gun it with this, basically. I'm going to move everything out of the way. I'm going to turn the extractor on. There it is. Break up all that wet liquid that I just put on, that paint that I just put on, and it's all going to be pushed together. And they're all going to blend nicely. I'm still going to be dry brushing on top of this, you see. Just to stop it from forming like a bead all the way around the bottom. It'll just take a minute for it to settle and then put some dab down up. It doesn't really matter that much if you don't get it all. So it's time to get started on markers, and I'm going to start off with the sort of greeny colour, the necrotic flesh. Needs to be pretty much like water. So 20 psi, and I'm going to be pointing down add in the green to his cheekbones and stuff. I'm just pulling back. And never let the air go. So you always keep your finger on the air. And just keep nudging it back. His wings on for a minute. pointy legs. It doesn't matter if you go over the edges here and stuff, because you have to touch this up anyway. Thank you. Now I'll switch to purple. Just a smidge. Oops, overdone it. Don't need that much. I'm operating at 10 psi and I'm using the custom micron CMSB. And this is just going to put some of the purple back in. Put his wings on again for this. I'm just going to hit his shoulders from the back. Sorry, this has to be done right, and I'm trying to get the right angles. See, now you can hear my compressor come on. now switch to the sort of a yellowy toned. We're getting there, Marcus. We're getting there. In fact, I'm just going to pause working on Marcus for just a second and bring this base back in because I think this has dried, which it has. So now I just need to coat this with some Nullen oil and some sepia. And so the last and final stage for today is to add a transparent clear layer. Clear. It's not quite clear, but you know. For this. Good Billy Ray. scopes and I'm pretty pleased with that so far. In fact, let's clear coat him just to protect him, that protects all these layers from the washes that are put on next, actually. So this is an enamel clear coat by Zero Paints. Still way too much. Should really put a respirator on for this, because this stuff is toxic as hell. But it's also very good. Watch all these colours pop. This will protect it for the next stage. That's 1 hour and 55 minutes. Well, in total, that's like, what, 2 hours or something? 2.5 hours? No, 3.5 hours. I don't think that's bad for 3.5 hours of it. So yeah, that's me done for today. On the next video, I'm going to add some washers and really make all of these details pop out and stuff. It's going to look pretty awesome. I'm also going to be dry brushing the base and his armour and stuff, his belt. Yeah, but I'm really pleased with the way he's going so far. To say I've never painted him before. So yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you find something that useful, and I'll catch you later.